pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Geneva. I'm Danielle Sambiring.
And I'm Maddie Johnson. In today's show, Sports Shield takes a closer look at our winter sports season.
And get ready for Geneva's fall play. All that and so much more,
because GTV News starts right now.
Here are your morning announcements for Wednesday, November the 15th.
This weekend, the theater department is proud to show off their hard work on the fall play.
She's got attitude.
That's good, right?
Tech crew, along with the actors, are putting on the finishing touches as they get ready to present Marvel Spotlight, featuring Hammered, a Thor and Loki story, and Squirrel Girl Goes to College. These are two short plays in one. Mr. Drew Longo says he is proud of his students.
I am really looking forward to them showing off their talent on stage. We've put a lot of work into this, and I'm really excited to show it to the school and the community. I think it's going to be really fun.
The show runs Thursday, November the 17th to the Sunday the 19th, and at 7 p.m. on Friday and Saturday, and 2 p.m. on Sunday. You can order the tickets now.
The fall sports season has wrapped up and the winter season has kicked off.
GTV's Vince Tichini brings us more in our last Sports Shield show before the break.
Vince?
Hello, Geneva. We got a lot of sports news today, so let's get started. Last Saturday, our Geneva varsity football team lost their state quarterfinals game to the Cary Grove Trojans 41-7. The Vikings were led on the ground by QB Nate Snapowski, who ran for 69 yards, and junior running back Michael Romero, who had scored the only Viking touchdown of the game. Finally, a big congratulations to the football team for all the hard work and effort that was put into the year.
It might be Ella Jean's to take.
This LT team.
Congratulations to the girls swim team for a very successful season. They wrapped it up by coming in 12th out of 104 teams that competed in IHSA state, being the highest ranked team since 2004. Claire Conklin qualified for three final events on Saturday and took 7th in the state in the 400 free relay. Amelia Murphy qualified to swim in two events on Saturday. She took 6th in the state and set a new team record. She was one of the highest ranked individuals in team history at the IHSA state for the second year in a row. Congratulations on all the medals. The boys varsity basketball team is getting ready for their upcoming season, and Geneva will be facing a lot of teams as we get ready to host the Thanksgiving tournament next week. And in January, we will be hosting the Day of Hoops MLK Shootout Day for the fourth time. Coach Scott Henning says this will be a great opportunity for our athletes.
We have 16 teams. We will host 8 sophomore games and 8 varsity games. This is our fourth year hosting the shootout, and it's teams all over the state. So it's a nice way to see other teams not in this area.
The Day of Hoops will be held on January 15th. The girls varsity basketball team is away game later today after school from 7 to 9 at Lake Zurich High School. The match is also part of the Hampshire Thanksgiving Tournament. All right. Let's get ready to rumble, Geneva. The annual Brawl in the Hall is coming to the Commons tomorrow afternoon. Wrestlers say this tradition kicks off the wrestling season, where coaches are already preparing students.
So basically, they will show us a move, either using a student or using another coach. They'll let us do it on our own time. They'll let us do student on student, to really learn more, and you know, they're really supportive.
Come down to the wrestling room after school if you are interested in learning more. The varsity bowling team is their game this week, tomorrow at 4, where we'll be playing Glenbard North High School at the Bolero in Glendale Heights. There will be a meeting for potential baseball players tomorrow in room KK265. See Coach Wendell for more information. There will be a boys lacrosse meeting in CC155 that will also be held tomorrow. It will be from 3 to 3:30 p.m. after school. The meeting will discuss open gym opportunities for workers and off-season workouts. That's all the sports news we have today, Geneva. From GTV, I'm Vince Duccini. Have a happy Thanksgiving break.
Thanks, Vince. And don't forget, tomorrow will be our PE department annual turkey trot. A 1 mile run around the fields, and over 100 teachers sign up to join the student for this year's event.
A college basketball coach who struggles with depression visited Geneva High School yesterday and shared his story of survival. Coach Mark Potter calls depression the silent epidemic, and he thinks that this needs to stop.
Something that we believe that your generation is going to change. You have to change the generation. Your generation has to change how we think about mental health.
Mr. Potter's Mental Health Matters presentation was shared with juniors and seniors. It was provided to the school thanks to the organization Kayla's Hope.
Cancer patients need your donations, so don't forget to bring your fuzzy socks in for the Haley Strong Sock Drive. It's sponsored by the National Honor Society, and your donation of new socks can be put in the boxes in front of Mac Olson Gym or in the main office. See Ms. Kershaw with any question.
There's another fundraising opportunity as well. The pizzas that the GHS marketing class created will be sold at Arulio's today and tomorrow as part of the proceeds go to No Kid Hungry. So be sure to stop by and purchase a pizza. The Skaldic Literary Magazine is meeting today after school in room B126. Email Ms. Peters with any questions. And now a look for today's weather. It will be sunny with a high of 61 and a low of 38.
And tomorrow for the Turkey Trot, it will be windy with a high of 63 and low of 41.
Here's three to know before we go.
All freshmen have a required PLC this week in auditorium. They will be selecting their classes for sophomore year.
National Technical Honor Society dues are due this Thursday. Turn them in to room EE171.
The speech team compete at St. Charles East Invite on Saturday. Des Angerman plays the fourth in original oratory, and Rosella Sorfax plays sixth in a prose reading. Congrats! Well, that is all the news that we have for you today. I'm Danielson Bidding.
And I'm Maddie Johnson. We leave you now with some pizza commercials made by the marketing students.
Have a wonderful Wednesday, Geneva.